My name is Yadin Dudai, and I'm from the Department of Neurobiology at the Weizmann Institute of Science, Rehovot, Israel.
And I'm Uri Nili. I'm also from the Department of Neurobiology at the Weizmann Institute of Science.
And here is Nachshon. Nachshon means a small snake in Hebrew. And Nachshon is a collaborator in our study. We are very grateful to Nachshon for inducing intense fear in the participants of our study.
We all have fears, but most, if not all of us, are also capable of acts of courage. That is, we can choose to act in a way that's contrary to what our fears are telling us. When we behave that way, we often find great satisfaction and gain much respect from others. But what does courage look like in the brain? Most courageous behaviors are unsuitable for laboratory investigation, mostly because they occur unexpectedly and are impractical to reproduce. To permit the study of brain mechanisms of courage, one must hence design an experiment which allows for controlled, reproducible courageous acts. We achieved this by looking at what happens in the brain of people who fear snakes while they overcome their fear. We placed the fearful volunteers in an fMRI scanner and placed a big live snake on a trolley on top of a conveyor belt leading to their head. The volunteers had control over the trolley and were asked to move it one step at a time as close to their heads as they dared. We also measured the physiological fear response using a method similar to that used in truth machines while they overcame their fear or succumbed to it. When we analyzed the functional brain scans and correlated them with the behavioral and physiological reactions, we found that activity in only two brain regions, the subganglial anterior cingulate cortex and the right temporal pole, was positively correlated with choosing to overcome the fear. Moreover, we identified the swift shift in brain activity that indicates that the person decides to act courageously. On the basis of our results, we propose how the machinery of the brain decides to overcome fear.
Our results shed light on brain circuits that underlie a respectable human virtue, while at the same time could potentially lead to a better understanding of what happens in our brain when fear prevails excessively, for example, in anxiety disorders and phobia.